In this session, we will learn about migration and its types, catadromous and anadromous. You must be very familiar with this term migration. Now, you must have heard and seen people moving from villages to towns and cities. Why do people move? They move in search of food or better opportunities and for better quality of life. So the same thing holds good even in animals also. And of all the animals, the one which is very popular for this term migration is fishes, because they move quite a lot of distance in order to achieve the goal. So in this session, we will learn what migration is all about, what are its types, and which are the species of fishes that exhibit this process of migration, and what are its significance. I am Dr. Lata, Assistant Professor in Zoology, Maharani Science College for Women, Bengaluru. Now, as we said, migration, it involves large number of population, whether it could be animals or humans, from one place to another for the purpose of feeding, reproduction, or to escape from extreme weathers, either to escape to hotter temperature or to escape the cold winters. Now, migratory behavior of fish is of a regular phenomenon, and their journey is purposed mainly for feeding and reproduction. And nobody teaches these fishes as to how they have to move, which direction they have to follow, and because it is their innate animal behavior, because this comes by birth. By birth only they know like how to move and which direction to follow, and hence they have become very successful migratory organisms or species. Now, we come across different types of fish migration based on their needs, like alimentary or feeding migration, when the search for feeding ground, or it occurs when feed resources get exhausted, they are bound to move from that place to another in search of food. Gametic or spawning migration, this occurs during breeding season to find a suitable spawning ground. Climatic or seasonal migration, that is in order to find a suitable climatic condition, either to avoid extreme hot temperature or extreme cold. Osmoregulatory migration, this kind of movements occurs when the water and the electrolyte imbalance occurs. They try to manage the water and electrolyte balance by moving from sea to fresh water and vice versa, that is from fresh water to sea. Juvenile migration, that includes larval migration from spawning ground to the feeding habits of their parent. Like, for example, the migratory movements that you see in lampreys, wherein the amosite larva, when it is it is hatched in a fresh water, and then again it moves back to its parental feeding habits to a ocean. So there it goes, feeds for 3 to 4 years, and again move back to fresh water for the purpose of spawning, and they die. So these are some of the examples of migratory fishes. In our further slides, when we discuss about different types of migration, we will be calling out these names, so it helps you to have a look at these species. One is Anguilla anguilla, the eel, Anguilla rostrata, which is also an eel, Anguilla vulgaris, and Solmosola, and Hilsa hilsa. These are the major migratory fishes. Movement of fishes during migration, like different fishes exhibit different kinds of movement when they migrate. So let us understand few terms what it means with respect to migration. When we say it is drifting movement, that means it's a passive movement of fish along with the water currents. dispersal movement. It means it's a random locomotory movement of fish from uniform habitat to diverse directions. That is, they start from one point and they disperse to different directions. Hence, they disperse. So, the name dispersal movement. Swimming movement. They are oriented movement of fish either towards or away from the source of stimulus. Denatant and contranatant movements. This is nothing but an active swimming movement. When we say denatant movement, it means swimming with the water current, while contranatant movement means swimming against the water current. Okay, denatant means swimming with the water current, along the water current. Contranatant movement is swimming against the water current. So remember these terms. Now, for the purpose of what is mentioned in the syllabus, fish migration are classified into these following types. Like, you need to learn about the anadromous and the catadromous migration, which is a part of spawning migration. So here, spawning migration can be divided into three types: the diadromous, the potamodromous, and oceanodromous migration. Now, diadromous migration includes anadromous and catadromous. Here, for anadromous, there is a typographical error. It should be ANA. Okay, just make a note of it. It should be anadromous and catadromous. So, anadromous migration is from seawater to freshwater, when fishes move from ocean to freshwater. Catadromous is from freshwater to seawater, the reverse of it. Whereas potamodromous migration is from freshwater habitat to another freshwater habitat. They remain in freshwater, but they move from one place to the other. Whereas oceanodromous migration is from seawater to seawater only, like the fishes move from one region to the other within the ocean. So in diadromous, you have anadromous and catadromous, and in the syllabus, it is mentioned only to learn about these two. So we'll take an example and we will learn how this migration and what are the changes that takes place during the course of migration. Diadromous migration, as we learned, it's the migration of fish between sea and fresh water. Changes in habitat may cause osmotic imbalance because they move from sea to fresh, that is from saline water to fresh water. And some regularly migrate to have perfect osmotic balance, and which is a key characteristic of a true migratory fish. So this kind of movement between sea and fresh water is of two types. One is anadromous migration and the other one is catadromous migration. We will learn one by one in detail. In anadromous migration, it is a migration of marine fishes from sea to fresh water for the purpose of spawning. Here, fishes spend most of their life living and feeding in sea, and they only migrate during breeding season to the river for the purpose of spawning. Such kind of migrations are called anadromous migration. Example for such kind of anadromous migration are salmon, hilsa, and lamprey. So they live and feed in ocean water, that is sea water, and they migrate only to fresh water for the purpose of spawning. Once they spawn, the larval forms, again they migrate back to their parental feeding habitat, and hence this keeps on continuing. Salmons, when they migrate for breeding during winter from sea to river, there are some physiological changes that takes place during this migration that mainly includes they stop feeding when they are on the way to the freshwater habitats. And they also result in a change in color from silver to dull reddish brown in color. And then in the meantime, the maturation of gonads takes place, and hence they get prepared for spawning. And once they reach the freshwater grounds, they select a suitable spawning ground and they make saucer-like or a nest or a pit in which the female lays eggs and male releases sperms over them. Now the juvenile larva, when it hatches out, it is known as alvins, and this alvins transform into par and metamorphose into an adult when they return to sea. That is how the anadromous migration occur. Here you can see the color change that is happening when it migrates from marine water to fresh water and back. The next type of migration is catadromous migration. Here the migration is from fresh water, migration of freshwater fishes to from river to sea during breeding season for spawning. Example, eel of the or the anguilla species. Now both European eel anguilla or anguilla vulgaris and the American eel anguilla rostrata, they migrate from the continental rivers to Sargasso Sea of Bermuda in South Atlantic for spawning, crossing the whole of Atlantic Ocean. Now, before and during migration, here they also exhibit some physiological changes which occurs in their bodies. They deposit large amount of fat in their bodies which serve as a reserve food during the journey. The color changes from yellow to metallic silver gray, and the digestive tract shrinks and stops feeding. Eyes get enlarged for and the vision becomes sharpened. Other sensory organs also will become too sensitive. And the skin serves as a respiratory organ. Gonads get matured and enlarged. They lay eggs in suitable spawning ground and are fertilized by males. After spawning, they die. The adults, whichever has spawned, once they release the gametes, they die. Maybe because they don't feed for a longer duration as long as they migrate. And once the gonads mature, they may lose all their energy in releasing the gametes and hence they die. The larva hatches out and develop into young eel and finally return to river. So such kind of migration is called as catadromous migration. Now, if you ask me what is the significance of such migration, mainly it helps, in search of food, and it results. So the main significance of migration is to find a suitable feeding and the spawning ground, for protection from predators, survive from extreme climatic conditions. It increases genetic diversity and it is an adaptational character for survival and existence. Just because they move from one region to other, they equip themselves to protect from their predators. They aim at finding suitable feeding ground and spawning ground, and also they can escape from the extreme weather condition. Above all, it helps in it increases the genetic diversity of these species, and thus migration is very important phenomenon. I hope you have understood this concept of migration and the difference between anadromous and catadromous migration. The main thing here you should remember is the definitions and what are the physiological changes that occur in these migrating fishes. Thanks for listening. These are the references from where the content is taken. Thank you very much for listening.